I'm not going anywhere. I'm not going anywhere. Bring it.
Some fighting words from a man who has every intention of winning the battle to survive. The last time we interviewed owner of EddieO's PourHouse and Kitchen, Eddie Oliveira, was back in November. You could sense his despair and struggle to keep his doors open after having to go through yet another set of restrictions. But coming up to now, the one-year anniversary of when this pandemic began, Oliveira says this fight isn't over.
If it hasn't been shot down now, I'm not saying we're bulletproof, but, you know, I expect to be here for a very long time. And I think the only thing that brings me to that level of understanding why I say that is because we deliver something that people want.
People like John Laurinsis, who says once Halton was put back in the red zone and he was able to head to a restaurant again, EddieO's was one of his first stops.
Oh, I gotta tell you, it actually makes it feel like the light at the end of the tunnel is still on and we can still kind of come out and enjoy ourselves, especially in a place like this. Like, Eddie's such a family-oriented person, and by that I mean it extends to the community.
And it is because of guests like these, Oliveira says he's lucky to be in a community that has been so supportive.
I can't imagine what's happening in Toronto. I can't imagine if we were in Peel that we'd be even sitting here today. The town has really rallied around our restaurant here, but also around the town. And I think the challenges that we get to face day in, day out, obviously the financial aspect is the biggest thing. We've been able to get support. But as we discussed previously, we weren't going to let this fall down. But we also knew that if we were to maintain our relationship and our connection with the community, that we can get through this. And we're still not out of it.
Although Oliveira is confident he will be able to get through this, he says it's hard for him to see when this roller coaster ride is going to end.
Biggest struggles are always being told, open, close, shut down, lock down, open, 10 people, nobody, patio. It's just this whirlwind of so much misinformation that it's where the struggles actually lie on. You know, I think it becomes after a year later, there is a reflection point where you get to go back to March 16th of last year and say, what? We're getting closed? And then to open again in the summer and invest more money for the protection of the guests that come in this restaurant, only to get shut down again. And then to be reopened again with more restrictions. And only to be shut down again. Seeing these restrictions now being, this past week about pharmacies and other now sort of non-essential stores being able to serve a percentage of their capacity. How come restaurants aren't allowed to do the percentage? That's one of the things that I always scratch my head over is like, you look at this restaurant and there's 10 people in it. And we've practiced social distance. We practice our contact tracing. We do all the protocols and guidelines set forth by our government. And we're always seem to be the last guys in line. This isn't about being essential or not essential. This is about small business. This is about a business that pays taxes. This is about a business that creates jobs and securities for people. You employ people so they can have a livelihood. You're taking that away from me, which is taken away from the experience. So now I have nobody working for me. I'm slinging around Main Street, dropping off French fries because I have to. But I don't mind doing it because you're telling me that's what I have to do. So the more I try to follow the rules, the more the rules keep changing.
And whether or not the rules keep changing, the hard work doesn't go unnoticed.
He stayed open. He's, I think, gone above and beyond. Anything I could do to support him, I'm so glad that he's open and he kind of fought through this.
A fight Oliveira has every intention of winning.
Whether it's your first time or your 40th time or your 70 or 17, we're here to provide you a memory, an experience, an opportunity to disconnect from your life so that you can come out and enjoy yourself for a day, for a couple hours. Actually, what's that? 90 minutes, an hour and a half max day.
Reporting for Halton News, I'm Melissa Candelaria.